Bladder cancer forms when the lining of the bladder wall undergoes a mutation that helps those cells to grow in an uncontrolled fashion. There are two different distinct pathways of the bladder cancer. The higher grade cancers progress by certain pathways, and the lower grade cancers progress by certain mutational pathways. Most well-known risk factors for bladder cancer are smoking, occupational exposure to chemicals, family history of bladder cancer, certain chemotherapy agents, pelvic radiation, and certain parasitic infections of the bladder. Bladder cancer is suspected by finding blood in the urine. Sometimes it's visible, and sometimes it's only visible under a microscope. Also by presence of irritative symptoms of urination, such as urgency, frequency, or pain during urination. When the bladder cancer is suspected, the workup includes examination of the urine for malignant cells, looking inside of the bladder with a telescope, which is called a cystoscopy, to identify and biopsy the cancerous lesions. And if needed, the radiologic examination is performed to identify the extent of the bladder cancer. So the bladder cancer treatment has two major branch points. One is influenced by the grade of the cancer, and the other one is influenced by the penetration of the cancer in the bladder wall. The low-grade cancers are usually treated by removal of the cancer's lesion, which is called the excision of the bladder tumor. And sometimes a single instillation of chemotherapy is needed, and sometimes there are additional chemotherapy, but they're all intravesical, that are needed as well. If the cancer doesn't return after a single instillation, there is still a periodic surveillance that's needed to monitor for the recurrence of the cancer. Higher-grade tumors require more aggressive therapy. The bladder can still be left in place, but they require more frequent surveillance. And if they progress or if they become resistant to chemotherapy, then extirpative surgery becomes an option. The bladder wall has three layers, and although all three layers are equally important in staging the tumor, the most important distinction comes when the bladder cancer penetrates into the muscle of the bladder wall. So the lower stage tumors, which are the non-muscle invasive, usually are treated by saving the bladder and resecting the tumor. When the tumor penetrates into the wall of the bladder, the muscle wall of the bladder, then keeping the bladder in place becomes a less preferred option. When the bladder cancer doesn't penetrate the muscle, resection of the tumors with preservation of the bladder is an option. And it's not a very complex surgery, however, it still should be performed by people who are familiar with the latest evidence-based guidelines to minimize the risk of progression and the recurrence of the bladder cancer. When the bladder cancer grows into a muscle wall, resection is not a very good option at that time. So the treatment becomes the removal of the bladder and the reconstruction of the new bladder or diversion of some sort with some combination of chemotherapy. When bladder cancer grows into the muscle wall, then the preferred treatment option becomes surgery with chemotherapy before or after surgery. In general, this is a technically challenging surgery. It should be performed by specialized urologists who are familiar with it. In general, there are three different types of urinary diversion. The simplest one is an incontinent stoma that drains urine in the bag. The second type is a neobladder, which is a continent urinary diversion that's made out of bowel and placed in a pelvis that's most anatomically similar to the pre-existing bladder. And the third type is a catheterizable continent pouch, which is also made out of a bowel, and it's attached to the abdominal wall with a catheterizable stoma, and the patients can drain the urine by inserting a catheter into it. So the urinary diversion is chosen based on the absence of contraindications from the patient's perspective and on the surgeon's preference. It's shown time and again that when patients go to a high volume centers with surgeons who are used to performing certain types of diversions, they end up getting more of the continent diversion types. Some patients can be candidates for bladder preservation. It requires a trimodal therapy, as we call it, which involves the aggressive resection of the tumor, leaving the bladder in place, chemotherapy, and irradiation. Some patients are not suited for that, so it has to be very carefully chosen for certain people, and the results are not as good as we'd wish because some people still progress and require removal of the bladder after a certain period of time. We do have a team comprised of multi-specialty groups, including specialized urologic surgeons, medical oncologists, radiation oncologists, pathologists, and radiologists that are very familiar with the treatment of bladder cancer, and they can help you pick the best treatment for you. We're also very fortunate to have a Greenberg Bladder Cancer Institute, which is a one-of-a-kind institution dedicated to the advancement of research and treatment of bladder cancer. We also have a multitude of clinical trials for patients with the non-muscle invasive cancers, muscle invasive cancers, and metastatic cancers.